So why is alcohol bad for the body? To answer this question, we're going to take a little trip of what happens to alcohol in the body. Once it's consumed, alcohol goes down the normal food path of digestion, from the mouth, the esophagus, and into the stomach. Here, about 20% of alcohol is absorbed through the stomach lining into the bloodstream, which means it's getting into the bloodstream very quickly. From the stomach, the alcohol that was not absorbed in the stomach next travels to the small intestine. One note here, if there's no food in the stomach, so an empty stomach, or if the alcohol is not consumed with any food, it gets to the small intestine very quickly. In the small intestine, the rest of the alcohol is absorbed into the bloodstream and travels to the liver. The liver is going to work on the alcohol molecules to break them down, making it possible to eliminate them from the body. So in the liver, an enzyme called alcohol dehydrogenase, which is also present in the lining of the stomach, which we will call ADH, oxidizes the alcohol or ethanol molecule. In basic terms, this means that the enzyme comes in and changes the chemical structure of ethanol. So ethanol becomes acetaldehyde. This substance is known to be toxic and carcinogenic, or in simpler terms, poisonous and cancer-causing. This acetaldehyde is then metabolized down to a substance called acetic acid, which is less harmful to the body. Acetic acid can then be broken down into carbon dioxide and water. When alcohol is present, the liver will work on metabolizing it first, so fatty acids can accumulate, which is why so many heavy drinkers develop fatty livers. If there's more alcohol than liver enzymes can handle, it gets circulated to all parts of the body. It's estimated that the liver can eliminate about 0.5 ounce of alcohol per hour, which is about 1 beer, 1 glass of wine, or 1 shot. When alcohol reaches the heart, blood pressure decreases and blood vessels relax. The heart then pumps the alcohol-rich blood to the lungs. Some of the alcohol in the lungs is breathed out every time you exhale, causing your breath to smell of liquor. The lungs send the alcohol-containing blood back to the heart, where it's pumped to all parts of the body, including the brain. Once alcohol enters the brain, it slows down nerve cells that control your ability to move and think. So judgment becomes impaired and movement becomes disrupted. Alcohol also increases blood flow to the skin, which may make some fair-skinned people turn pink, and some people will begin to sweat, and most will smell like alcohol. Alcohol also decreases the body's production of antidiuretic hormone. Antidiuretic hormone helps your kidneys manage the amount of water in your body. The decrease of this hormone causes the kidneys to not reabsorb water. Instead, it is excreted as urine, causing the body to become dehydrated. If alcohol consumption continues, it could lead to loss of consciousness. And massive alcohol consumption or binge drinking could lead to alcohol poisoning. This happens when there's a high concentration of alcohol in the bloodstream, and this could result in coma, respiratory depression, or possibly death. Now let's look at the after effects of alcohol overconsumption, the dreaded hangover. The exact causes of a hangover are not completely understood, but there are several factors that may contribute to it. The chemical acetaldehyde is formed from ethanol. It's believed that this chemical is what causes the headaches associated with hangover. The increase in urination leading to dehydration, which could cause thirst, dry mouth, and dizziness. Some immune cells produce substances called cytokines, which can contribute to nausea and fatigue. Some alcoholic beverages increase the release of gastric acid in the stomach and delay the emptying of the contents of the stomach, which could be the reason for stomach pain associated with hangovers. Alcohol can also interfere with the liver's production of glucose, the main form of energy for cells, which could contribute to dizziness, disorientation, and lack of energy. The long-term effects of alcohol overconsumption include anemia, which is a low amount of oxygen-carrying red blood cells. It can lead to cell death in the liver cells and brain cells, leading to these organs not functioning properly. The risk of heart failure increases, as does the risk of stomach and intestinal problems, and many heavy drinkers have high blood pressure. Overconsumption of alcohol can also lead to relationship problems, depression, and employment problems. And these are just a few of the long-term problems associated with constant overconsumption of alcohol. It's always about moderation, folks. Limiting yourself to 1 or 2 drinks from time to time is probably a good strategy. As you can see, overconsumption of alcohol has a lot of negative effects on your body. And consistent overconsumption of alcohol has catastrophic effects on your body. And that be alcohol. Moderation, folks, moderation.